In this video, I'm going to be going over a very powerful video converter called UniConverter. You can do a lot in the software, such as converting videos, compressing videos so they're a smaller file size, and also making some minor editing adjustments. So if you're ready, let's take a look at UniConverter. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
So one of the questions I get asked a lot as a video editor is, how do I quickly convert video clips from one file format to another? And a good way to do this and a fast way to do this is to use a standalone software such as UniConverter. This is my go-to app now for converting videos, especially if I'm trying to create proxies or just trying to convert video clips from one format to another. So just to show you here, when you open up UniConverter, this is the home page, and at the top are the three main tools: the converter, downloader, and compressor. Let's take a look at converter first. I did also want to mention that if you do want to try this for free, you can start a free trial. I'll leave it down in the video description if you do want to check out UniConverter. But inside converter, you'll see an area where you can drag and drop your video clip, or you can click the add button in the top left to add a file. I'm going to convert this video file here. So as you can see, it's an MP4. Maybe I want an MOV of this. Maybe I'm re-editing this video and want a proxy of this video made, so it makes editing the video in Premiere Pro a little bit smoother. What I would do is click load. This will load it up here. And as you can see on the left side, it lists the current settings. So MP4, the resolution, the file size, and the duration. And then the arrow in the middle. And then on the right side, you can see what it's converting it to. So in this example, MOV, it'll be 2.2 gigabytes, so it's getting larger. Same resolution and the same duration. But if you want to make changes, you can click this little gear settings icon right here. As you can see, this brings up this window. So I'm under the editing window, but you might see it on default under the video tab here. As you can see under video, you have a lot of different file formats that you can choose from. A lot of the very popular options such as MOV, MKV, even AVI or HEVC. And then if you're on a PC or need to convert WMV files, there's an option for that as well. If we even go down further, there's a lot of different phone options as well, such as 3GP. So you can sort by different types. So I'm in the video tab. If you needed to convert to audio, there's an audio tab. Maybe you want to convert to a WAV file. There's that option for you as well. But where I was under editing, and this is what I use most commonly for UniConverter. So say if I wanted to convert this file to a proxy format, what I can do is select ProRes Proxy and then click on same as source for the resolution. That way it's going to convert it from MP4 file format to an Apple ProRes file format, so it's easier for Premiere Pro or my video editing software to read. Before we convert this, I do want to mention that down below you can see where the file location is going to be saved at, the new file. So in this case, I have it set to my downloads folder, but you can change this by clicking the drop down and clicking on other to choose a different file destination. Once you have your file location set, you can click start all at the bottom right or click convert next to the individual ones. You can load more than one file at a time as well, so keep that in mind. So I'm going to click convert, and you can see it converts it very quickly and easily from an MP4 to an MOV file in just a matter of seconds. Another common thing you might want to do as a video editor is compress your video files to make maybe a video file a little smaller so it's a little bit easier to work with. So to do that, we can use the compressor tab. So if we go over to the compressor tab, similar to the other options, you can click and drag in here, or you can choose the file at the top left corner. So if we click this button, I have this video clip of a countdown timer. But as you can see, it's 320 megabytes. I want to condense this to save some file space. So to do that, I'm going to click load and add this in here. And similar to the converter tab, on the left side, it lists the file type, resolution, duration, and also the file size. So you can see it's 320 megabytes. And on the right side, it'll show how much it's going to compress it to, somewhere between 112 megabytes to 224 megabytes. And if you need to adjust this, you can click on the little settings button here, and this option will pop up. What's really cool is you can change this depending on your video clip. So say if you want it really compressed, like a small file, you can drag it all the way to the left, but it comes with this recommended range. So, you know, if you do all go all the way to the left, you'll notice that it will be very small and it may be very compressed. But if you just want to decrease the file size by a little bit by also keeping most of the quality, then I recommend just keeping in the screen range here. And this still compresses the video by quite a bit here. Once you're good, you can click OK. And once again, at the bottom left, it'll show where it's going to be outputted to. So in my downloads folder, and we can click compress at the top right. All right, so once it's done, we can go back to our Finder and we can see that we have our converted file. And it's a little bit smaller here. If we go to our Finder, you can see it's 207 megabytes, where the original is 320. Now, another common thing I do all the time as a video editor is maybe I have a clip, but I just want to trim it. You know, I don't want to make a new project inside Premiere Pro, open it up, import it, you know, name it, make a new sequence and trim something. Maybe I just want to do a simple task. That's where the video editor tab comes in handy. So if we go to the video editor tab, you can see that you can do a lot of different basic video editing adjustments, such as trimming clips, cropping. So in this example, I'm gonna trim a clip. So if we click trim, we can choose the video that we wanna trim. Maybe I have this countdown timer and I wanna trim it so that it's a 1 minute countdown timer instead of 5 minutes. So I'm gonna click load and you'll notice a basic timeline window pop up here. What we can do is click pause to pause the video. We can go out forward in time to the spot that we want to trim the clip to, maybe around here. Once we're there, we can click this cut button right here, and this cuts the clip in half. We can click the clip on the left and click the trash can to remove it. And now we have just a 1 minute countdown timer here if we click play. Once we're good with our edit, what we can do is just click OK. And once again, similar to the other controls, it lists the source on the left and the output on the right. Now you will notice that it is a MOV, so we can change that by going into our settings and we can do MP4 same as source to make sure it is the same exact video setting from the input to the output. Once we're done, we can click save and this will save that video. Once it's done, we'll go into our Finder here. And as you can see, we have this finished 1 minute edited video. They have a few other options here as well I did want to highlight. So they also have a screen recorder as well. So if you wanted to record parts of your screen, you can choose that. If you work with DVDs, they do have a DVD burner as well. And then some of the other cool tools they have under the tools section, you'll notice that they have this AI lab. They have an AI video enhancer. So if you have some low res noisy footage and you want to make it more cleaner, more crisp, you can use this tool to clean up your video footage. They also have the AI image enhancer as well. So it improves clarity of still photos. Then they have an AI script generator similar to ChatGPT, where it can create a script for you. And then another really cool feature in here is text to speech. So you can actually write in or copy and paste the script in here and have different voices say your script for you. So you can generate essentially AI voiceovers directly in the software. They also have a lot of other different AI tools as well. So I recommend giving it a try. You can start for free today, download a free trial, see how you like it. Let me know what you guys think in the comments section below. But that pretty much does it for today's video. Let me know if you have any questions, and until next time, take care.